Foreign nationals living in South Africa are worried that the violent protests there are likely to resurrect acts of xenophobia experienced about 2 years ago. Philip Kakuru, a Ugandan businessman in Johannesburg, told NTV that the current crisis has been fueled by the biting effects of the lockdown, unemployment and poverty.
As the Minister of State Security indicated, that there are elements of former state operatives behind these riots. So there's the third force behind all this, which is raining on the distress of the people and the frustrations.
He says both South Africans and foreign nationals' businesses have been affected by the ongoing protests.
We've been locked down, and we're not getting any government support to that effect, unlike the second wave. Small businesses have closed down, those who don't have insurance. And it's that situation that has prompted people to come up in arms.
At least 45 people have now died in the violence that has been engulfing parts of South Africa since the jailing of former President Jacob Zuma for contempt of court last week. This includes 10 people killed in a stampede during looting on Monday night at a shopping center in Soweto, the country's biggest township. Almost 800 people have been arrested in the unrest that turned violent over the weekend. The military has now been deployed to help the overstretched police. President Cyril Ramaphosa has called it some of the worst violence witnessed in South Africa since the 1990s, before the end of apartheid, with fires set, highways blocked, and businesses looted.
The path of violence, of looting and anarchy, leads only to more violence and devastation, as well as suffering. It leads to more poverty, more unemployment, and more loss of innocent life. This is not who we are as South Africans. This is not us. It is therefore a matter of vital importance that we restore calm and stability to all parts of the country without any delay.
Soldiers working with the police managed to catch a few rioters, but law enforcement remains heavily outnumbered.